This is Gothik the Harvester. We'll split the raids. We'll have a couple of tanks on this side, and all casters on this side, and we'll have a couple of tanks and healers and melee on the other side. So the essence of this fight is just a survival fight. It's like a rend event from UBRS, where you just fight waves and waves of mobs, and you have to kill them in specific order, so you don't overwhelm this side and the undead side. And you just survive for, I think it's about 4 minutes, and after 4 minutes he will start teleporting down. He'll teleport in between undead side, which is the side Blas is currently standing on, and he will teleport to the living side, which is the side I'm currently standing on. And we'll have all three of our marked up tanks. They will be standing as close to this as possible, because the mobs, they will spawn directly on top here, and caster will be standing back. Keep in mind, stuff on this side dies really easy, so we should be careful to not kill stuff really fast on this side, because that means that the undead side might get overwhelmed, and yeah, so we might have to stall some time, like shackle mobs, and yeah, just keep them. Keep a perfect balance between between the sides. On the other side here, on the undead side, the piles, the mobs will, the spirits will run to the piles and spawn. You'll just have to run in between. I won't assign five tanks or five warriors to pick up the mobs. Like, and the reason we have all the melees on one side and all the casters on the other side is because the mobs on the other side is spell immune. But I think they do not resist holy damage, so if you're a red paladin or a protection paladin, you should be fine standing on the other side. And so the killing order on this side is the horse riders, then the death knights, and then the trainees. But on the undead side, you kill the trainees first, because you see the arcane blast they
do. Do not continue. Turn back while there's still time.
So if we have a overwhelming amount of mobs on our side, and we'll just keep them CC'd and wait for the other side to catch up. And the killing order on the other side is the trainees, then the rider, then the oh, he ran through the wall. Nice. Then the it's trainees, then the rider guy, then the death knight, and somehow, for some reason, they added a fourth. When we kill the rider on the living side, it will turn into two mobs on the other side, and the horse is the last target to kill. Okay. I have never seen anyone through the wall there, but okay. Let's see if I can see it. Yeah, as you can see, it spawns as a rider and as a horse. And the death knights we should be able to shackle. Same with the riders, if they get to be too many. But I think with our current DPS, or world buffed or not, we should be more than fine. So, while I wait, any questions?